This week, a visual treat, as artist and latest TV reporter Julie Anne Gilburt visits Lewes for the 2010 Visual Arts Festival, Artwave.
Welcome to Lewes District Artwave. So here we are today in the Hop Gallery. It's bigger than this, I'm just in a corner. And that's part of the Star Brewery in the heart of Lewes. Very historic county town. You have to come here. We're going to dash around and see as much art as possible, but there's masses of venues, lots of artists, and so follow me and then come next week and see some more.
Artwave runs across the Lewes district, and we have 94 venues and in excess of 450 artists taking part. Artwave takes place in people's houses and garden sheds and garages and businesses, and it's a means of generating interest into the visual arts.
We're going to go in and have a look. It's very exciting. It's all about the Tate Lewes.
I've noticed the nudity.
Whether it's nudity or anything like that, it doesn't matter.
I like your bus.
Thank you very much.
Hello.
Hello there.
Mark.
Yes, nice to meet you.
I'm Julie Anne. Can we come and have a little look?
Please do, yes.
You're a writer.
I'm a writer, yep. Evidence of progress. A little marker placed in the sand for the purposes of navigation. A rough note scrawled in the margin of a dog-eared page. Been there. Thunk that.
And you've got lots of other artists here as well.
And it's sort of a hive of activity, as well as accommodating three painters in different studios in the space. We have a sort of principle in the studio of privacy as well, so that people don't go in and poke their nose. I mean, some studios you get are quite open plan and everyone's involved with what everyone else is doing. Here, we're all slightly secretive.
Listen, can I be putting the kettle on while you do this?
Yes.
All
right. There's something really quite spectacular about seeing the art in the artist's studio. Poor Rachel, she just wants a cup of tea. And we've interrupted her.
Can I make you one?
No, because we've got a dash in a minute. Thank you.
Thank you. See you soon. Bye-bye.
Okay, so we've had a really colourful experience in Lewes. Lots of interesting colours, paintings, chatting to people. We're now going to go and find some more art, more venues elsewhere, a little bit further afield. Just gonna have a little drive. I'm not walking in these hills. Our travels have brought us here to New Haven Fort. In my little book, we're now off to see the Children at War exhibition. These pictures are by Claire Hackney. I'm not gonna go around it with you and say anything because it's so powerful, these images, I'm gonna cry. So you have to come and see yourself. Don't just look at the images, look at the words as well. Absolutely fascinating. Start with a banner that she made when she was first protesting against the Iraqi war, and then work your way around. Fantastic. Nice to meet you, Victor.
I live here. This is the room I work in. It's mainly boats, houses, and nauticalia. Marine assemblages, I now call them.
So we've been to Victor's house. We are now at the Hillcrest. Your sense of colour is absolutely out of this world.
Thank you. You know, it's just the journey of painting, really, and keep doing painting things you love.
The Hillcrest Centre is a community centre. I'm a trustee, and everybody who's a trustee is obviously does it voluntarily. 12 years ago, it was rescued from development, and since then, it's been built up into a fabulous resource for local people and anybody who wants to come along to rent rooms, rent space. It was very supportive of the arts.
We're at Jeff and Mark's house. They won Best Open House last year, so I'm quite curious. Follow me.
The weather sort of turned into winter almost, didn't it?
I waved my magic wand and we have sunshine.
Now, if I'd known you were coming, I'd have made a plate of cupcakes, because they were particularly popular last year.
The idea is that people look at the garden.
It's also been selected as part of a group in Seaford to be in the National Garden Scheme next year as well. Mark's studio is at the top of the garden with his paintings in. I can't believe you've got the sun.
This is sort of work I did before it became, you know, influenced by the landscape work, if you like. It's the contrast that interests me, you know, with the landscape. That's what's really interesting. This worked out so well, actually, and also you're in control when you show your own work like this. However small the space is, at least I'm in control here, you know, put it as I want to, which is good.
So if you come to Jeff and Mark's house, you'd get cakes too. And look, savoury cakes, sweet cakes. Peter, which one are you going to have? I'm going to have the pretty one.
She's horrible, isn't she?
We're now all the way out in Ripe.
My name's Jessica Zoob and I'm a painter, and I usually show my work in Cork Street and in Hoxton Square. And
that's the proper galleries in London, the proper artist.
And now I'm showing my work in Ripe Post Office, and once a year the whole of this area does a lovely festival, and so I join in, and I always show my work in my own studio as well, which is in Lewes. And it's a chance for people to just come and see what I do, and so not to be intimidating, because galleries can be quite intimidating. Okay. So it's a really nice, friendly festival to come and...
You need hours and hours to sit and look at that, don't you?
I think that's really such a lovely comment, because the paintings take a couple of years to make, generally, sometimes even longer. This is Carl Smith, and he's the sculptor. He's made this bench. Hand over.
Carl, tell me about your bench.
The sea groins inspired the work and the seating area. Basically, I've just looked at these were square boards and thought, as it's pieced together, what would the water do and how would it erode the wood? This is a sample piece of work that I can do for people's houses. You know, the handrail, people like the bench. And they like its form, and the form is something that I just enjoy to make. On top of that, I made these rings that are then welded in, and that sort of reflects the way that the steel work in the sea groins, sometimes it gets so eroded away that you wonder how on earth it ever got there in the first place. It's very tactile. I think if it feels right, it is right. And this is a collaborative thing, projects with Jessica, so you can probably see her work within these.
We're at the greenhouse in the village of Ripe, which is a very picturesque village in the heart of the county, and we have a fantastic open house here with numerous artists all exhibiting a variety of works. It's definitely a must.
It's so quiet, and the birds and the sunset, and it's beautiful. We're going to try and find some artists, some sculptors. We're going to start in the garden first while it's still light.
My work is very unique. It's very different to what's happening, what other people are doing. It's kind of in your face. It's almost like an object from another world that has sort of landed, plonked itself in a garden.
They're stunning.
I've discovered another gorgeous and amazing artist, Nicola King. Tell me about your work.
Well, I paint from life. I paint with a group of artists in a studio in Lewes, and I also paint commissions, nude commissions, and portraits.
I tend to combine silver with felt. I like the contrast between the two materials, the kind of harder, colder metal with the warm, soft.
And I like the fact that you're wearing your art as well.
Mismatch with the gold and the silver, but you know.
Starting a new trend.
Yeah, exactly.
Why not?
That's what it's all about.
It's quite a difficult concept sometimes for people to understand that the item of jewellery is precious because it's been designed and handmade. And made
you're an
with
artist
love.
And I've got a piece of art.
Yes, but it's not necessarily made from precious materials, so they don't have to put it away and, you know, hide it.
Hide it in the bank.
In the bank or even in a drawer. It just has to be looked after and loved because it's precious.
As a beautiful piece.
As a beautiful item, yes.
I make my work from recycled materials. So the main body of my work is made from old electrical wires stripped from the interiors of old buildings. The outer layer, the colour, is actually wrapped with colourful thread and then gold wire to hold it in place. The gold wire comes from the insides of telephone wires.
When somebody told me that you do recycled jewellery, I thought, here we go, loads of Coke cans cut up into little bits, but they are absolutely stunning. I think you've done a really good job. This is Theo Nisa. I spotted his work earlier and I was absolutely blown away by it.
At the moment I'm drawing people. I've done all sorts of things from performance work to abstract gestural work. This is what I'm doing at the moment.
You've added paper there?
Yeah, that's right.
No,
yeah.
You haven't been scared to just give up?
No, it just...
It's grown and you've added paper.
A lot of my drawings just grow and become quite large until they don't really fit on the drawing board, but I do them bit by bit and add pieces as it seems appropriate.
Because that would not have been the same, would it?
No.
Not without the hands.
That's right, yeah. So you get to that point and then you suddenly realise, well, you need hands. Who said that? Max Bygraves.
We're so conditioned.
You need hands.
Yes, you do. There they are.
Sorry.
What's your favourite colour?
Blue.
Why?
I don't know. I just love it.
Red. Because it's bold and vibrant.
At the moment, I'm really into this magenta pink.
Reds, actually. I love red.
I suppose it's probably a sort of a green.
Blue.
Red.
Yellow.
Red.
Orange.
Blue.
Red.
Blue.
Brown, I think.
Red, probably.
Purple, yeah.
Always been green, yeah. Plus yellow and white.
Blue. But also like green.
Red.
Well, it used to be green, but it's what you're wearing now. Pink.
Your colour, the pink.
Blue.
Purple.
Green.
Mauve.
Mauve.
Blue.
So many reds.
Yeah.
Red. Everyone. Red. How many reds have we had? Loads. Peter, what's your favourite colour? He doesn't speak.
My favourite colour?
Well, being a writer, you've got to think very carefully about
white.
The answer.
Moss.
Pale grey.
I haven't got a favourite colour.
It's a lilac-y pink colour. It's a pink, but it's a bluey pink.
Blue,
I suppose, yeah.
A blue man.
It's almost impossible for me as a painter to say a single favourite colour because I absolutely love the way colours combine.
Red.
Red?
Yeah.
Why is that?
Because it's strong.
My favourite colour? Oh, my goodness. It depends on the person. my favourite colour, really. Pink.
Pink?
Yeah, pink.
Pink?
Yeah, it's got to be pink.